Hey Seafood Loggers, welcome back to my channel Culinary Vlogs by Z. If you are back, that means that you are enjoying my vlogs and thank you for that. If you are new to my channel, please consider subscribing to be updated on all my vlogs posted regularly. So today's vlog has absolutely nothing to do with the Easter Bunny. But if you are celebrating Easter, I hope you have a wonderful weekend. Today we are making a very popular fast food that originated among the Indian South Africans of Durban in South Africa. It is called the Bunny Chow. Today I'm going to show you a delicious fast food that has originated among Indian South Africans of Durban, and it is called the Bunny Chow. Now what is a Bunny Chow? It is a hollowed out loaf of bread that is filled with curry, and this can mean any curry of your choice. It can be a vegetable curry, a chicken curry bunny, or a lentil curry as well. It's entirely up to you. But in today's vlog, I'm going to show you how to make a lamb mutton curry bunny, which is my favorite. So to the oil, we're going to add in one chopped onion. And in here, I've got a few cinnamon sticks and I've got one heaped teaspoon of jeera or cumin seeds. And I'm going to add this to the pot as well. So wait until the onions have browned. So we're just braising the onions. Every Indian curry starts with braising of onions. Well, almost every Indian curry. So use one large onion because the onions give it that extra gravy. So I suggest if you have small onions, use two small onions, otherwise one large onion. So once the onions have browned, you're going to lower the heat to medium heat and add in 2 teaspoons of ginger garlic paste. Then 1 teaspoon of salt. And of course, 1 kg of diced leg mutton. So I've trimmed off all the fat from this leg mutton. Give this a quick stir. Then we're going to add in 2 cups of boiling water. So once you've added the boiling water, give the meat a quick toss and you're going to leave this to soften. So you're going to leave the meat to soften. And this would usually take about 45 minutes. So once the water has halfway evaporated, we're going to add in a few other ingredients, and that is 2 teaspoons of chili powder. Then I've got 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric, 2 teaspoons of coriander powder, 2 teaspoons of cumin powder. And I've also got 4 tablespoons of tomato puree. And then I'm going to add in diced potatoes, and this is about 2 medium-sized potatoes. Then leave this in the pot to simmer until most of the water has dried up and the gravy has thickened. This usually takes about 15 to 20 minutes. So now remember that the curry has to be a little thick, otherwise if it's watery like this, you're going to have a very soggy bunny. So can you see how the color has changed? And also the gravy's also gotten a bit thick. See? It's not watery and runny. So I'm just going to leave this for another 5 minutes and then remove it from the stove and get our bread ready. So look at what an amazing color this mutton curry has. And most of the water has evaporated and the gravy is actually nice and thick. It's not liquidy like before. And the color we actually get from the tomato puree. I'm going to leave this for a few more minutes and then switch off the stove. So this is a little tip. If you're making mutton curry or chicken curry or any type of curry, and you find that there is still a lot of water and that the curry has cooked for too long, then all you need to do is put the stove or the plate on high and leave that to simmer for about 10 minutes, but watching it, of course, because you don't want to burn it. And see how quickly the water evaporates from the curry. So this is a loaf of bread, unsliced, that I picked up from the bakery. And you can either cut this in halves or you can cut them in quarters, depending on how big you want your serving to be. So I'm going to be cutting this into half because I'm going to be getting some guests and I just need 2 portions so that they can share. You're going to cut off around the edges, like so. And then simply remove the center portion of the bread. Just scoop it up like so. And then you're going to have a loaf with kind of like a hole in the center and a topping. And the next thing you're going to do is place in your mutton curry into the center, like so. So you're going to fill it up until it comes to the top. Okay. And then taking this piece, I'm going to dip it in some gravy. So before we put on this piece, we're going to garnish it with some coriander. Oh, doesn't that look lovely? And then place that on the top. And so here you have it. Your bunny chow is ready to be served.